Okay, so let's look at our question for today. The question today I have from one of my IELTS students is it better to have a British accent or an American accent for the IELTS exam? The question is a British accent or an American accent better for IELTS? Well, what do you think? What does IELTS stand for? Well, IELTS is International English Language Testing System. So let's think about the I, international. It's about being able to speak English at a good enough level internationally in an English-speaking country. So does it matter if your accent's more British? Does it matter if it's more American? I don't care. Something about me maybe you don't know is I have a British parent and an American parent. I'm a British citizen and an American citizen, and my accent changes a lot. It depends who I'm talking to. Maybe the problem is that a lot of students think pronunciation means accent, but accent is a really small part of what it talks about in the marking criteria. The main thing it talks about is that accent doesn't stop intelligibility or being able to understand the students, even at the highest level. So that means if you're Korean and you sound Korean, speaking with a Korean accent, it doesn't make any difference as long as all the English words sound the same. So what's pronunciation really about? Because as you can see, the criteria talk about lots of different pronunciation features. So what it's really about, more than accent, is just things like stress, syllable stress, word stress, sentence stress, rhythm, intonation, and very high-level features, which are kind of connecting pronunciation to meaning, like contrast of stress, for example. And I can talk about all these things in future videos because, as I said, pronunciation is just as important as everything else, grammar, vocabulary, and fluency. But a lot of people don't realize that pronunciation is just an equal part of it that's going to get the same score between 1 and 9. So how important is accent exactly? Well, again, like with everything else, you just have to look at the examiner criteria or the public version available to everyone. So you can see the accent is really not that important, and it's not something really worth getting very worried about like some candidates do. So that's all from me, everyone. Please write down any comments or questions you might have, and I'll try my best to answer those in the next video. So thank you, everyone. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.